Hi guys, thanks for joining me for another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'm going to be going over how to use Insert Target right after this. Okay, so before we get started, go ahead and look in the description and you'll be able to download this from a download link. So, insert target is right up here, and if you don't have this up here in your Affinity Designer, go ahead and go to View, then go to Customize Toolbar, and then you'll be able to stick it right up there. From right here, so you can just grab this and pull it up here. So, go ahead and do that if you haven't done that yet. And so what insert target does is if you select one of these, it will determine where your next layer goes. So for example, if I wanted to make a bluish strip going across Dallas 2017, including these little stars shapes, then I would go ahead and click on the rectangle tool, and then I would click on this layer. And it's really important to click on the layer before you make another layer or use any of these tools. So once I've clicked on this layer, then I'm going to go ahead and click insert target, this one, which makes it inside. So if I pull it, it will make it go right inside there, and I'll be able to adjust it to however I want. And also, it creates sort of like a group, but it's not really a group, but you can still open it. And it's a parent-child relationship between these two layers. And then you can, you know, mess with it to however you want. I'm going to pull this one up a bit, make it a little longer. There we go. Okay, now we're going to I'm going to show you how to do these ones and what they do. So if I wanted to make a square behind this, that's sort of grayish, then I would just click on this layer, click on square tool. So I'll go ahead and click on the behind insert target, and then come here and click on square, and then just draw my square. And obviously I don't want it to be blue, because then you can't see the middle of Dallas in 2017, and go ahead and adjust it. And then I'm going to turn it on a black, and then pull it down a little bit. Okay, this isn't necessarily how I would keep it. It's just an example that I'm doing for you. And also the other one works the exact same way. It just puts it above. So I hope this tutorial was useful to you. And again, if you want to download this, it's for free. Just go ahead and look in the description, and you can download it and use it for anything you want. I did it of Dallas because that's near where I live, and I just really like Dallas. So go ahead and like this video, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe, because I give out free tutorials and updates. And also, if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below, just right down there. And so I hope you check out my other videos, and thanks for watching.